Kansas. Archery season for deer and bear 2022. And I just wanted to give you an idea of my surroundings right now. If I do get one, I gotta drag him out in the dark and all this shit. So, that'll be interesting. What might be better, actually, is if I drug him the other way out to the road, put my gear on it, and then drive back around. Either way, I'm gonna have to come back through this later tonight, so. Let's go see what we can see. Come on. It's a great big atlas, and I'm feeling down. When you got what you want, baby, I should start over. There's nothing. So I'm about 100 yards-ish away from my final destination. And I ran into a bed. It looks like a pretty good size one too. Check it out. Size bed. So that's a good sign. There's not much for him to eat up here, I don't think, but it's pretty damn thick, so it's a pretty good bed spot, you know. I'm gonna keep going, come on. Sure, that's probably a buck bed because it's the only one there. I don't see any others. I've been told that does bed in kind of a circle with all the does facing a different direction for protection. I don't see that there. It's just a very defined single bed. Kind of cool. And shrubs running away, I could probably see my stand from here. Here we go. So I'm taking a little break in the shade here. Pretty hot. It's about upper 70s up here. Anyway. It's been cooler in the evening and in the morning, but not so much during the daytime. It's been less humid though, so that's good. So, this area is the same spot where I told you all about that buck that's bedding 9/10 of the way up the ridge. He's almost impossible to sneak up on. So I drove around about a mile, and I'm walking in a half a mile. Scent up into the sky instead of going down there. Now this evening, before it gets dark, the thermals will start dropping instead of rising as it gets cooler. So I have to watch out for that. There's a few things. There's quite a few things that I have a disadvantage of in this contest between me and this deer. He's got the edge on me on a lot of stuff. However, one of the things that I do have going for me is something that's working for him as well, and that is in this dry environment. We've been in a drought. In this dry environment, it's going to be really hard for anything to sneak around in the woods without you hearing something. So hopefully I can hear him. Safe. Keep me sane. Please keep me sober. Help me to do things your way. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on. I'm starting to rub into starting to run into his rub line. I don't know if it goes straight across or comes down over, but I'm fixing to find out. I think my stand is a little bit over that way because I remember that dead tree up there. Well, there goes my attempt at being quiet. And this may be another little buck too, I'm not sure. But there's a little oak sapling there that's been given to once over pretty good, so I'm gonna head up this way and kind of curve around. I should run into my stand fairly quickly. I feel like I need to move my whole set over here somewhere, like in that oak tree or something, just because I found his rub line back there. So there's deer definitely moving through here. This big open spot in the middle of all this thick stuff. I guarantee a deer moving through here on the regular. Set up and hopefully have a good little set. Here we go. Here we go. Boy, the sun's right in the way, isn't it? Anyway, hey everybody. I am now up in my new spot and the wind's blowing in my face and I fucking love it. So, I'm going to rant for just a second. If I can get this sun right, I'm gonna rant. There we go. To the person that stole my SD card from my camera. The correct Linnaean nomenclature for your species is Cocksuckeris americanus, dumbassimus. I'm gonna turn so you can see me. Cocksuckeris americanus, dumbassimus is your fucking name. Here's what's gonna happen, folks. I can all but guarantee that the first one is gonna happen. second one has a pretty good chance of happening. But it's not 100%. First thing that's gonna happen is the guy who took my SD card with a picture of a buck or two on it at that scrape is not gonna kill that big buck. Because that man is too stupid to kill that big buck. He didn't know that there was another camera 10 yards from that one facing the other direction. And that 15 yards from that is that buck's bed. He doesn't know that. He just came along, saw a scrape and an SD camera and thought, oh, I'll take this. Use this for my scouting. So 100%, whoever you are too dumb to kill that buck. He's way smarter than you. And I hope that buck lives to be 20 fucking years old and dies of old age. The second thing that's not quite 100%, but I think has a pretty good chance of happening, is I'm going to kill a public land buck, whether it's a spike or a forky or whatever, right here this season. Not even 100 yards from where I was in the first place. I think that's going to happen. Because I did it the right way and I did it the hard way. I walked in through the thick stuff for a half a mile uphill, trying to judge the wind as I came up. And you didn't. I scouted properly for months and you haven't. I found the rest of the rub line and the rest of the scrape line from that buck and probably at least one other, and you haven't. So you can stand on my shoulders and try to be successful. You might kill that buck, but I highly doubt it. I have a better chance because I'm smarter than you. I work harder than you. And that buck is sure smarter than you. So have fun. You can have that spot. It's yours, even though this is public land. That's all I have to say about that. Now, I'm gonna sit here and eat my apple and take a break and enjoy my new spot, which is a little white oak tree, by the way. And I'll show you what I'm looking at. Scrape is right there. No, right there. Like 33 yards away. He's got a line of rubs and scrapes all the way down there, or at least rubs. I can see everything from, I can see probably 60, 70 yards up the hill. That's the same ridge line that goes down into the oak flat. Last time I came up that way and walked over this way. But there's no way to get up there quietly. This way I had to come through a damn jungle. Still wasn't quiet, but I don't think too many people do that, so. I've got the cedar thicket to my back. So we'll see what we see. Should be interesting. Should be a fun sit anyway. This is not a bad little spot. Sometimes I forget how peaceful it is out here. Just to come out and enjoy nature and enjoy the creation. person honestly thinks that someone didn't make all of this. Freaking awesome. They don't want you to know that they're there. Just saying, a thief is worse than a poacher. Sure is pretty up here. I can see some big time mountains just south of me. I'll give you a look-see. Seem very big to you folks from out west, but this part of the world, that's about as big as them mountains are gonna get. The shadows are starting to get a little bit longer, so maybe that's good. There's quite a few animals bedding in this thick stuff up here, and as the sun goes down, they'll start getting up, moving around. And if they do, maybe they'll move around underneath my tree stand. Update from the deer blind. means I've got about an hour and a half of light left. We'll see if anything happens. Even if I don't see one, I'm on some pretty good sign. This would be a good place to hunt. It's a good area. If it doesn't get pressured too much, probably, but it's a good area. I've been sitting here watching this woodpecker just tap away on his old dead tree. Well, y'all, no dice, but I think this is a really good place to hunt, so I'm going to keep it for as long as I can. There are several beds in here, too, so that'll be interesting. Anyway, I got to go about a half a mile back through the thick shit now. Here we go.
There, she's a welcome sight, laddie. Yeah. Oh, man. All right. Oh, baby. Hello, Chevy. Oh, yes. Oh, nice. I have a feeling people used to camp out here a long time ago or something. I don't know, but I sure am glad to be back. Woo, cheering.
Well, folks, that's the end of another hunt. I know I was not successful today when it comes to putting a deer in the freezer, hanging one up from the front of the cabin, but I found a good little spot, and hopefully this time the rapscallion that stole my SD card will keep his grubby hands away from my stuff. Other than that, it was a pretty good hunt. I enjoy just getting out there and finding new spots, scouting new spots, getting on sign, learning to read sign, and then eventually, God willing, putting a deer on the ground. Or a bear, maybe one of these days. It's going to pay off. Hard work and dedication gets rewarded by the Lord. That's all there is to it. So, until next time, have fun, shoot straight, be safe. And, don't put your fingers on other people's shit. That ain't right, man. It ain't right. Love y'all. Later.